Let's see what happens when I send a few of these steel nuts down this trough. If you think that's crazy, wait till you see what it does with my gold and black sands.
Hi again, folks. Al here from PLACERTOOLS. Today I want to introduce you to my latest product. This is my concentrate separator. It may look like a high banker, but it's not. Now, I originally designed this as an option for guys in the gold room who didn't want to spend the money on a shaker table. This will do a pretty good job for you. Even though this was originally intended to be for a gold room, as I developed it, it became apparent pretty quick that it had way more uses than just that. One for sure is working beach sands. You could probably shovel your beach sands directly into the hopper without even classifying it in a lot of cases. You could use it for a dry blower situation. And the most important one to me is that if you took a modified version of this, put it at the top run of your sluice on a commercial plant, you could pull the magnetics out of your sluice run before it starts to clog up your expanded metal or your mats, whatever you're using. So that would be an important factor for somebody, especially if they're plagued with the with magnetite. If that's your nemesis, this is your machine. And also, if you're working with in an area where you don't have as much water, if you clean the magnetics out, now your runs are going to work a lot better, even with the reduced water flow. As far as processing speed, I can run through a 20 liter bucket of minus 1/8 material in about 15 minutes. So you want to know how it works? I'll run you through the procedures and the features.
To start with, you have a hopper. It has a flat edge plate for a blanker and a second one that has different size holes in it to process different size material. There's a flat plate under here that the spray bar will squirt water at, and it flows up into there. It just basically promotes the material that's in the hopper to flow down into the tray. The tray is 10-inch aluminum. It has four of these regulators. The upper three are all identical to this, and the final one has many more holes and slots in it. And essentially, that helps to even out the material as it flows towards the next area. But it also prevents any surges of material overwhelming the magnets. The gold trap, as you can see, is easily removable from its position. So as the material flows down the tray, comes to the drop area, and the influence from the magnets on the drum start right about here. And there's about a 5-inch influence area. So, and this area is constantly full of water. So your material all flows down there. Your gold will essentially get trapped here. Your lighter material will flow off the end and down into a catch tub down there. And your magnetic material will flow across or through the material, get strung together as things do with the magnet. And then from it hits a point about here, and then it goes vertical to the magnet on the first drum. So these drums have internally fixed magnets. By fixed, I mean that the magnets are in a one position, and the only thing that rotates is the outer drum. On the primary drum, the magnet is right at the base. And as you can see, I've got alternating slots, and that's to prevent overload of magnetic material is tending to stall the drums. So as if the material gets attached to a smooth portion of the drum, while it rotates, that material is going to want to stay right at the base, and it'll roll itself around on there and cleaning itself of gold until one of the pickup grooves comes along and grabs the material and brings it up to the top. From there, it's going to lose some of the influence of the lower magnet, and then the secondary drum magnet will take over, and that material will leap across to the secondary drum. Meanwhile, you also have the spray bar here, so you're going to have a rinsing effect. So gold will also get rinsed off, and it'll land down with the discarded lighter material. From there, your magnetic material will simply roll around the outside of the second drum, be rinsed off by the second spray bar onto a tray, and you can catch it into a separate container. What I have here is a solid 15 pound steel weight. And one of my drums, as you can see, no problem. The water delivery system is an 800 gallon rule pump, and I've made a screen for it just to keep the organics from plugging up the jets on the spray bars. So the rest of the components consist of a 12 volt drive motor, a pulley system, a control valve, and a splitter there, which gives you a small working hose, so that helps with processing your material, and of course a battery. The material I'm using today is a mix of magnetite, blonde sands, and gold, of course. And I'm only going to do a small amount. I'm not going to bore you with a full bucket of this stuff. I've sped the video up here just to take up a little less time. Here you can see the discharge. I've slowed it right down so you can get a good visual effect of the magnetics going into the pan there. And you can see the material banking up against each of the regulators there. 911 Mining has expressed interest in doing a product review, so I'll probably send this machine down to them here very shortly. And if you're not subscribed to them, I'll leave a link to their channel below, and good idea to get yourself on their list and get notifications, and you'll be able to see what they've got to say about it. This is my only advertising, as well as word of mouth, so if any of you guys know people who might be interested in watching this video or looking at the product or a version of it, then please forward this on to them. It'd be much appreciated. So we'll see how much gold is in this gold trap. For this demonstration, I'm going to use one of my own gold pans. For a small amount of material, I don't need the dam with that. This one has the winter handles on it. And that's actually why I'm doing this inside, is that it's sub-zero weather out there this morning. A little too cold for this old timer, with or without the handles. And for those not familiar with this pan at all, I sent one to 911 Mining, and they did a YouTube video on it, essentially testing this pan against a conventional round pan, and with the same material, and we sent the tailings in for an assay to see which pan lost more. And the round pan lost 1.42 grams per ton. This one lost 0.01. So as unconventional as it may seem, it catches fine gold very, very well. Quite a bit of gold there. Okay, now we'll check the black sands that were captured with the magnet. Nothing. And I don't have to practice that. That's the way it is every time. So lastly, we'll check the material that came off the end of the gold trap. This should be mostly the lighter material. Use one of my floating magnets to gather some of that magnetic material. I see maybe three or four of the tiniest little pieces of flower there. So I have had 100% recovery of gold through the gold trap, depending on how fast you push the material through, and of course the size of the material as well. So there's a few factors that might influence that, but the gold trap turned out way more effective than I ever dreamed it would. When I'm putting these things together, I will make sure that there is a gap underneath these guides, and that way anybody who wants to run this as a sluice, they can put their favorite mat in there, full length, and run the tailings or any other material through the hopper, and that way everything would also go through the gold trap and the magnetic pickup.